This is Roger Bong. You're listening to Patterns. Our mic sounds pretty good, I hope. We got Dehan here with me. He's going to ask some questions. He's working on a project for an upcoming show he's organizing. J Dilla tribute show at Blue Note on February 5th. Tickets are on sale.
They're on sale.
J Dilla.
Right, J Dilla. Light Sleeper started in 1997 as a college radio show on KTUH. So yeah, it wasn't even clothing back then at all. No apparel.
Yeah.
Until about 2000, 2003.
And yeah. The rest is history.
Yeah, it just kind of took off. Yeah, I got a shot, man. I mean, I know a lot of talented individuals that helped me out. You know, I didn't do it by myself, so.
I started Aloha Got Soul as a blog in 2010 or 11. Prior to that, I was collecting records, making beats from vinyl, of course. And then found out about these like local records that I never knew existed and started blogging about that. And then four or five years down the line, I turned it into a record label.
DJ Drama has been around everywhere in the scene here in Honolulu. Who are some of the people that you have worked with out here?
Just pretty much a wide range of artists, producers, tastemakers, musicians.
Yeah.
Pretty much everybody under the sun.
So much.
It's all organic, man. Dilla's super organic. You know what I mean? Like his beats is. Yeah, you know what I mean? I appreciate it. The more I do a Dilla Day and analyze his stuff and listen to it, the more I start appreciating the way he sampled it.
Yeah.
His drums and everything. The unsynchronicity, I don't know what you call it. It's just the way it's right. Like it's like thrown out there, you know?
Yeah.
You know, his ear heard it and we hear it differently, you know? So.
Yeah.
Producer wise, I can still study a lot of his stuff and still can't figure it out. You know, you could chop samples all day and it sounds like chops.
Yeah.
The musicality to it, that's why like, what you had said, you can't tell if he's playing it or if he chopped it.
Right.
You
right.
know, and that's the part that's crazy for me. Because it's like maybe he did play one part but chopped this, but was able to merge the two together to just make it one piece.
I think if I were to like sum it all up, when I hear music that he's created, it has a lot of heart. And there's a lot of music out there that has a lot of soul. But like, J Dilla's music has soul, but it has a lot of heart. And I don't know how else to put it.
Monday the 5th, we got the Blue Note Dilla Day with you guys. The 7th here, Wednesday, we got our Dilla Day, and hopefully we'll have them back, your band back here for Saturday.
The reason why we're fucking with you, I should say, is Dehan and Nelson Cho and a few other people, they've been working really hard to put together a J Dilla tribute concert series, which they kicked off late last year. They did a show at Hawaiian Brian's. They're gonna do a show at the Blue Note. And the Blue Note show is happening February 5th. They have a string of special guests who are going to join them. And they're basically playing covers, I should call it covers, of J Dilla songs or songs that J Dilla has produced. I know D'Angelo is definitely in there somewhere. He's not going to be there, but they're going to cover D'Angelo's song. That's February 5th at the Blue Note. Tickets are on sale right now. You can grab those. Support local musicians. Support music with heart and soul.